5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। वी नाउ कम टू द रेगुलेशंस दैट कैन बी फ्रेम्ड रिलेटिंग टू प्राइवेट अनएडेड प्रोफेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस। इट वुड बी अनफेयर टू अप्लाई द सेम रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस रेगुलेटिंग एडमिशन टू बोथ एडेड एंड अनएडेड प्रोफेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस। इट मस्ट बी बॉर्न इन माइंड दैट अनएडेड प्रोफेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस आर इंटाइटल्ड टू ऑटोनॉमी इन दियर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन वाइल एट द सेम टाइम दे डू नॉट फॉरगो आर डिस्कार्ड द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मेरिट। इट वुड देयरफॉर बी परमिसिबल फॉर द यूनिवर्सिटी आर द गवर्नमेंट एट द टाइम ऑफ ग्रांटिंग रिकग्निशन टू रिक्वायर अ प्राइवेट अनएडेड इंस्टीट्यूशन टू प्रोवाइड फॉर मेरिट बेस्ड सिलेक्शन वाइल एट द सेम टाइम गिविंग द मैनेजमेंट सफिशियंट डिस्क्रेशन इन एडमिटिंग स्टूडेंट्स। दिस कैन बी डन थ्रू वेरियस मेथड्स। फॉर इंस्टेंस अ सर्टेन परसेंटेज ऑफ द सीट्स कैन बी रिजर्व्ड फॉर एडमिशन बाय द मैनेजमेंट आउट ऑफ दोज स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव पास्ड द कॉमन एंट्रेंस टेस्ट हेल्ड बाय इट्सेल्फ आर बाय द स्टेट आर यूनिवर्सिटी एंड हैव अप्लाइड टू द कॉलेज कंसर्न्ड फॉर एडमिशन वाइल द रेस्ट ऑफ द सीट्स मे बी फिल्ड अप ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ काउंसलिंग बाय द स्टेट एजेंसी। दिस बिल इंसिडेंटली टेक केयर ऑफ पुअरर एंड बैकवर्ड सेक्शंस ऑफ द सोसाइटी। द प्रेस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ परसेंटेज फॉर दिस पर्पज हैज टू बी डन by the government according to the local needs and different percentages can be fixed for minority unaided, unnominated, unaided and professional colleges. The same principles may be applied to other non-professional but unaided educational institutions, that is graduation and post-graduation non-professional colleges or institutes. There is no controversy relating to provisions of the Act and rules where procedure for admission to professional colleges is prescribed. The only dispute that arises for our consideration is validity of Rule 12, which was introduced on 19 June 2019. The object of Rule 12 is to ensure that all admissions to medical institutions are based on merit and to bar students of lesser merit from getting admission to better colleges. The notice issued by the Director General of Health Services, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India has been referred to by the High Court in its order dated 24 April 2019. The said letter highlights the active participation of a group of students who were blocking all India quota seats in second round of counseling deliberately for financial gratification without intention to join the medical college for doing medical degree. During the said period in the letter, nearly 1000 आइडेंटिफाइड स्टूडेंट्स डिड नॉट ज्वाइन आफ्टर फर्स्ट राउंड देवर बींग नॉमिनेटेड टू फाइंड आउट वेदर देवर टेकिंग एडमिशन एट लीस्ट इन सेकेंड राउंड DGHS proposed severe penal action against those indulging in such activities. Having been informed of this mnemonic, this court passed on order barring students who take admission in the All India quota seats from being allowed to vacate seats after second round of counseling. All vacant seats after last round of counseling were directed to be filled up from a list that is forwarded to the institutions in the ratio of 10 times to the number of vacancies to ensure that all stray vacancies are filled. The contention of the appliants is that being asked to keep seats unfilled amounts to an unreasonable restriction on their right to carry on their occupation guaranteed under Article 19 of the Constitution of India. Even assuming the object of the rule is to ensure that lesser meritorious candidates do not get admission to better colleges, the measure adopted by the government in keeping seats vacant is disproportionate. This court in state of TN versus P. Krishnamurthy and others held that a subordinate legislation can be challenged on the following grounds: lack of legislative competence to make the subordinate legislation, violation of fundamental rights guaranteed under the Constitution of India, violation of any provision of the Constitution of India, failure to conform to the statute under which it is made or exceeding the limits of authority conferred by the Enabling Act, repugnancy to the laws of the land, that is any enactment, manifest attributions or unreasonableness. It is relevant to examine whether a subordinate legislation can be declared as unconstitutional on the principle of proportionality. This court in Kerala State Beverages Corporation Limited versus P.P. Suresh held the challenge to the order dated 7 August 2004 by which the respondents were deprived of an opportunity of being considered for employment is on the ground of violation of Article 14, 19 and 21 of the Constitution of India. Lord Diplock in Council of Civil Service Unions versus Minister for the Civil Service held that the interference with an administrative action could be on the grounds of illegality, irrationality, and procedural impropriety. He was of the opinion that proportionality could be an additional ground of review in the future. Interference with an administrative decision by applying the Bednesbury principle इज रेस्ट्रिक्टेड।